Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Shishir Poddar. He's the CEO of Tirupati Graphite. Shishir, very good to speak to you today.
Yeah, same here, Stephen. Good to speak to you.
So you're out with trading results for the year to March, and it looks like a pretty good year for the company. Shipments up 50%, sales revenue up 76%. Take us through some of the highlights.
So, Stephen, these results actually speak back of the acts that we did during the year to get us back on track completely. So as a result of that, what is most significant is our gross profit margin for the year has increased 170%, and the gross profit margin is back to the range of close to 50% for the entire year. It was much lower in the H1 results. So if you correlate that as to what it is in the H2, it actually exceeds 50%. Overall, I think we took a lot of steps along the projects last year, and I think we can see the fruits of that now coming in the results. Overall, a very great achievement in spite of all the difficulties we had earlier last year.
So, take us through some of those difficulties, because one of those was bottlenecks. And you do mention in the commentary today that you've managed to overcome some of those bottlenecks.
So, Stephen, earlier last year, the weather conditions were very, very bad. And it led to a failure of certain road infrastructure, led to our projects getting cut off, and also, our internal infrastructure getting, out of use. And we then took a series of decisions on how to tide over this situation, in the forthcoming period. And they were implemented right away at the projects at a very, very emergency pace in a way. So the most significant thing I think that has helped us is the decision to split our process into two parts, a pre-concentrate unit and the final concentrate unit, which actually meant that the transport of ore from the mine to the processing plant got eliminated and replaced by a slurry pumping system, and also reduced the total load on the transport itself. So altogether, all this reflects in our results, the steps taken. There have been numerous RNSs describing all this, and I'm sure our investors who look at us are aware of them. What I can tell them now is all that we did last year, 100% was in the bullseye, and that shows in our results.
You continue development across the two projects. You also reached plant capacity of 30,000 tons a year, and you had your first commercial shipments from Sahamami. So take us through some of those highlights as well and those achievements.
Yeah. So, the Sahamami 18,000 ton plant started only, fag end of last financial year for us. We started ramping up in March, and within the same month, we started our first commercial shipment from that plant. So that's quite fast. You will see other companies in the mining space taking months and months together to, achieve this. We did it right away. Having said that, now our task is to achieve the 30,000 tons capacity at our plants in physical operations, and we are seized doing that. And I'm sure we will achieve that. It may take its time to reach that level, but not too long for sure. Having said that, coming to the next steps, I think we have an opportunity to increase the capacity by another 6,000 tons to 36,000 tons with very small changes in our Vatumina project. And we have studied that. And as we start accumulating cash, we will go ahead and implement that.
So all this while there was also a focus on reducing your operating costs and also a focus on renewable energy. How important is it for you to get that renewable energy installed?
Well, so our first small little hydropower plant that, we built, Stephen, is now up and running. It gives us a small quantum of power, just about 100 kilowatts, but it has a significant impact and gives us the way forward. Right now, there was a team on ground to do the final, assessments for an extra 400 to 500 kilowatt hour plant, which we will take an investment decision on, not too far away. And that would mean that once that is up and running, we will be almost 70 to 80% of the power costs at Sahamami will be borne through renewable energy. On the OPEX side, we've shown that we have the ability to produce graphite at possibly the world's lowest OPEX. I'm not including China here. We don't know much about them, and possibly even there, producing graphite at the OPEX that we have been doing now is quite a shot in our arms.
So now that you've completed the first phase of your development into a sustainable flake graphite company, what's next, Shishir? How's 2024 looking for you?
Stephen, as you will recall, we also completed the acquisition of another asset in Mozambique, which has its own advantages, while our Madagascan assets are scheduled to be developed to a level of 84,000 tons, in total capacity. Once we have now, substantially stabilized our operations, we will be looking at what we should do next, and we'll update the markets. But definitely, our idea is by end of 2024, we will continue to target to reach a plus of 80,000 tons total capacity across the company, whichever project, whichever arena we'll choose the best, and try to reach our target, which we've set, 2 3 years back.
Well, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress as you achieve that target. Shishir, thank you very much for the update today.
Thanks a lot, Stephen, and thanks for connecting on this very vital day for us.
You're welcome, Shishir Poddar, the Chief Executive of Tirupati Graphite.